I am literally editing the video for this week, and I didn't do an intro. So I'm like, you know what? I could wait till tomorrow and do an intro, or do it now. And y'all can see me in the lighting. It's not that bad, so I'd rather do it now. So we're doing the intro for this week's video. anyways, what's up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. I gotta go to work soon. Just wanted to do a quick little clip to include in the vlog. Today is Frank's birthday. So, happy birthday to the little bro. I feel like there's a lot that I could say about him, and I will probably end up talking for hours because I've known him for almost a decade now, and there's so many memories that are created and so many things about him that I haven't really seen in a person before, and I really haven't had in a friendship before, which is what I love about a friendship. It's very unique, and it's something I've never experienced with people before. So, like I said, I've known him for the past 10 years. I've watched him grow, and even though it's only been 10 years, like, it's not like I've watched him grow since he was like a little kid or anything. It's been like nice seeing him grow up and be the person that he is today. He's a whole 21-year-old. What? Like, it's just mind-boggling to me. Like, when, like, it's one of those people that you've known since they're like 10, 11, and when they've reached like the 20s or whatever, you're just like, how? In a sense, that's what he is to me. One of the most important people in my life. Very, very grateful that he met my cousin, Junior Sixtus. Very grateful for the memories that all three of us have created together. And even now, like, the memories that, as much as I love you, Junior, even the memories that me and him create now, and just kind of, again, I love my cousin so much, and I wish he was here, but I think even him being away and just me and him just bonding, the both of us, without my cousin, because for the longest time, it's been me, him, and my cousin, and I hadn't really gotten the chance to know him just on, like, an us sort of level sort of thing. So even the past year of my cousin being gone, again, as much as I love him, I've also enjoyed bonding with just Frank. He's one of the sweetest souls. He's so kind. He's hilarious. He's annoying, but again, what little brothers are not annoying. And he's just one of those people that I can, and I felt even the past 10 years, that I am able to talk to and literally say anything. And yes, sometimes he does judge me, but he's judging me from a sibling sort of perspective and not from, I don't know how to explain it, but that sort of makes sense. Like, sort of like, you know how siblings, you joke around and you judge each other in like a playful sort of way. That's basically what he does, and that's why the stuff that he says or whatever, I know are jokes and I don't take them personally, but if someone else that either didn't know me well or I wasn't as close with said it, I would have definitely taken personally and gotten hurt by it. He's someone that is not afraid to tell me the truth and tell me when I'm either being annoying, I'm either being dumb, or just plain out stupid, and he just doesn't care. I mean, not that he doesn't care how I feel about it or, like, whatever, hence why I don't really, like, because he knows I don't really take it personally, but he will straight out tell you the truth. And I appreciate that as much as sometimes it's like, wow, I appreciate it so much, because we all need someone like that in our lives where they just will tell you the truth straight out. He's been there in for me, like, multiple times. He's, even though he is younger than me, he has given me great advice as shocking as it sounds for people who don't know Frank on a deeper level, and it's just like, that kid gave you advice. He has given me advice. And have I followed them? Maybe. But he has given me great advice that even sometimes I'm like, I probably should have listened to him. We've seen each other. We've been with each other, like, even through the bad times and whatnot. And, yeah, I mean, he's just family at this point. My whole family loves him, to a point where my youngest cousin, who has basically known him her entire life, calls him our cousin, which he is at this point. And it's just someone that my whole family loves, and we adore him, and we are so, so, so grateful for him, and so grateful to have him a part of our family. I think he's one of the few people that we've all, like, accepted into the family, in a sense. And we're all very grateful for him. To a point, I think even, well, he definitely met my grandpa. Like, he's met my grandpa before, and he was even there through that time that my family was grieving over my grandpa and him passing away, which I feel like that's one of the reasons why we love him so much, because he's just there, and he's there not only for my cousin. I mean, he is there for my cousin, and literally, my cousin would probably, he's one of the few friends of my cousin's that he stuck by him, in a sense. Well, not, yeah, one of the few friends that stuck by him and been there, and through all of his crazy, my cousin's crazy phases, someone outside of the family that has experienced, like, his crazy phases. And I don't know, I guess, long story short, because it's going to be long, he's amazing. Frank, if you're watching this, which I will probably make you watch this, I love you very much. You're one of the most important people in my life. Him and my cousin, who's turning 20 this year, which is crazy. Probably gonna weep when I'm creating that video for him for his birthday, but that's not about him, because it's not his birthday yet, it's Frank's. Anyways, you're one of the most important people in my life, in our family's life. You've been there, again, I'm kind of repeating myself, but you've been there for my cousin, for me, for my family. And yeah, we appreciate you, we love you. The best little brother that I'm so glad I don't have, but now I do, because I'm stuck with you. But yeah, we love you. Happy birthday. Hope it's a great one. You're probably gonna see him, like, I don't know if it's the next clip or not, we'll see, probably not the next clip, but I will take him out for ice cream this week, and you'll see him, and that sort of will be my kind of present to him, because I am the type of person that for someone's birthday, I'd rather just have me and them time and spend time with them in that sort of way. And yeah, so you'll probably see him later in the vlog. And yeah, I don't know. Happy birthday, Frank. I love you. Hope it's a good one. Hope 21 treats you well. And just know that I'm forever going to be here for you whenever you need me. And yeah. What's up? So my jumper sort of kind of ripped, I guess. It's a romper, not a jumper, sorry. And I thought this would be interesting content of me trying to sew it back together. So I'm gonna do a time lapse of me sewing it, and then I'll come back and show the results, or see how it goes, sort of thing. Y'all, I'm gonna call myself a sewer from now on because
I actually did it. I don't know if you can see. I mean, you're not supposed to see, which is good, but I actually did it. Let's try. I don't know if you can see that blue stuff. But I did it. Like, what? Look at me go. I know how to sew. But yeah, I want to try and do another pair of pants and see if those will work. But they're not like torn, but I want to kind of readjust them. So we'll see if I can do that. And if I can, your girl's gonna be doing her own readjustments for her clothes from now on. Cause, like, yeah, let's see.
I already made the marks for the pants, so now all I'm gonna do is cut them and sew it and see how it goes. Hopefully this works out well because you can only do this once. Worst case scenario, I'll just take it to Fundi and they'll be able to readjust it for me, but see if I can do it by myself first. And if I can, you guys, I'm gonna be DIYing a lot. But yeah, time for a time lapse. So far, yeah, I hope this actually works so I don't have to go to Taylor and actually get it done or whatever. But wait, 1 second. Now we can start. So I'm done with my little project. That's what it came up to. I'm gonna go try it on. And I will show you how it looks like. Fingers crossed this works out well. So these are the pants. It's actually not that bad. I just need to find a way to put this, because right now it looks like I have a pocket and I don't. So I just need to find a way to sort this out, but to make sure it looks proper. But for it to be tighter, it actually became tighter, and I'm very proud of myself. It kind of looks like it's not even and one is higher, but I feel like, you know what? Fashion, let's just leave it like that. But no, it's actually tighter than it was before. Yeah, so let me figure this out, or I'll probably figure it out another day. Other than that, it was a success. I think I'm gonna be doing more DIYs. Maybe. We'll see. But yeah, that's your girl's sewing work. Just a little explanation that I'm gonna keep short, but these next few clips are a time where one of my church friends was leaving to go to the US, Dorothy. I'm gonna link down her YouTube. She has a YouTube channel, so I'll link down her YouTube channel below. English. Anyways, so we went to her place and we chilled there. It was a Sunday, so it's like kind of like the last Sunday hangout with her. And yeah, so we chilled there, we went out, we walked around, and that's basically what it is. Dorothy, if you see this, we miss you and we hope you're doing well. And yeah, that's that.
Then it will be around. What you will miss about your or fond memories, or if you wanna wish her well. One more thing. Where is the
Look.
Content creators.
Small segment of the last session he has of my data.
Yeah.
Okay, you just David though, because maybe you wanted it now. Just David.
Anyway, they can't hold it.
There's a lot. Like, any, it's how you decide something and you just do it. And you don't procrastinate. And it's just great. I mean, you're very, very multi-talented in so many ways. And you're very inspiring. Seeing you do what you do, seeing how you are creative, how you're diligent, how you always asking questions, how you're always looking inwards, just you're always searching. Most people don't try and do that, and it's great. You're looking for answers and you're doing it the right way, and you're asking God for direction, and you're always asking for your purpose there in so many ways. And I've loved seeing you going through all these seasons, and it's great how you just persevered, and you're in so many disappointing situations. Like, Ini, you always stand back up and show so much love and blessing. Like, Ini, I can say there's a moment, and I remember, I think we're going to drive towards Upanga, and you said something really phenomenal when you were talking about other people, not about yourself. You said, Dani, I want to be blessing to other people. Yearning. I was like, dude, that's so selfless, like, yearning. For once, I was like, oh my God, I'm in a cup, and I gave up myself. Like, Ini, there's this girl who feels like she has, I feel like she has everything. Like, Ini, first, she's talking about helping other people, being blessing to other people's lives. It was so, it was grand, yearning. It really humbled me. So, yeah, I love that about you. And yeah, I just hope you continue to be that, be blessing to other people, because honestly, we need you. And just hope you just continue being obedient in that way. And, what I want to miss is just the same way what I love about you. Like, Ini, it's going to be sad not being here. Like, Ini, I'm okay with it, because you're going to the next step. Just people are going to be blessed, you being there. And you to shall enjoy. Should say thanks to God. We've enjoyed your company, your power, and your blessings. It's time for other people to get the chance to experience that. So, yeah.
That was good.
They don't have chips, yeah. They don't have chips, yeah.
So guys, we're talking about
never go out with Ino. You can't leave the place with Ino.
And I can believe.
The one that orders KFC 50k. We want an ice cream. What did you say?
You got in here one zito.
Eh?
Scared Yoto.
Yeah, all of a sudden. No, no, no. Nyumbani, mimi napenda nyumbani.
Yeah. Unapongaika, what are you? What?
Kweli mpajua ni laki moja. Kume ni F2. Subiri ni ambele.
I'ma do an outro. Anyways, thank you guys so much for watching this video. The next week is gonna be, it's gonna be like a vlog sort of thing, but not like a proper vlog. It's more like kind of like a challenge sort of video thing. So stay tuned for next week, because I'm trying to change it up and not do vlogs every single week. So that's next week. And yeah, don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to my channel, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.